a man driven off the road by the police, and he wasn't doing anything wrong. The cop just got upset. Here's the video.
You better pull up. You better pull your ass over. Pull your ass over. Pull your ass over now. Pull it over now. You better pull your ass over. Pull the over. No, pull the over.
This is insane. This is insane. The man literally put on his hazard lights to indicate he's pulling over at a safe place. When you look at that road, you will clearly see it is a dark, dark street. No natural lighting, obviously. No street lights are in the view. He informed the police officer what he was attempting to do. The cop would not listen. This ordeal took place within a couple of minutes. It wasn't as if there was some high-speed chase or some one-hour follow. This wasn't even a dangerous situation for other people until the cop decided to make it dangerous for everybody on that street. Now, Antonio Risco tries to find a safe spot to simply pull over. This is exclusive. Dash cam video just got released from the Lamar County, Georgia Sheriff's Office. You could hear the man say, I'm going to get off at the next exit. Sergeant Brayton, right? Sergeant Brayton decides to use a pit maneuver to drive off the road, completely violating policy order. Aggravated the Lamar County Sheriff deputies, command Risco to step outside. Here it is.
Get out of the car. Crawl out of the car. Now. Don't you move that goddamn hand. Get on the ground. Get on the ground. Get on the ground now. Get on the ground. Get on the ground now.
Get the fuck up. I have a phone recording everything.
There's a dog right here.
Live streaming everything. As we speak.
Forward.
Hey, everything. Everything.
They put the dog on him. He has a natural reaction as any of us would have. And the deputy says, stop fighting my dog. Let's put the picture up full mass. This is a damn shame. I'm gonna give you all of the background to this exclusive. This is Antonio Risco, 23 years of age at the time of the incident. The incident took place in 2020. We just got the video today. This took place in 2020. They tried to hide it, but we got it. Risco was returning to his home in Canton, Georgia. He told Indisputable he did not stop immediately because he spoke with an officer earlier that day who said he could put on his emergency lights and signal to the police to get off a busy highway. Here was the aftermath of that Dodge Charger. It was actually a 2019, it was a brand new model in 2020. Just got it. Here's what Antonio said to Indisputable Investigates. The last 30 minutes of audio actually cut out. and I screamed bloody murder for the EMTs to take me to the hospital. The cop kept blocking me from talking to the fire department and tow truck drivers so someone could get me help. He continued, I literally thought they were going to kill me. They had their knee on my neck like they had George Floyd. I was getting full force knee on my throat. I was about to pass out and just managed to slip out at the last moment and just took the biggest breath I have ever taken in my entire life. He was trying to survive. For 15 minutes, police wrestled, tased, and hit Risco with their nightsticks. Visible in the video, here you see one of the deputies gets ready to strike Risco with his nightstick. Look at that picture. Look at it. At another moment, one can hear a taser repeatedly fired. Next, they sic their police dog on Mr. Risco while he is subdued in handcuffs. Here is the German Shepherd that they made attack Risco. Risco told Indisputable when he was getting mauled by the dog, he was in handcuffs and could not move. He says he heard the K-9 deputy say, quit fighting my dog. Risco says he has severe neck and back pain from the attack. He still has bite mark scars on his arm and his torso. Risco says he was in a holding cell for 16 hours before nurse treated his wounds. He could barely move for 2 weeks. Put up the attorneys. You don't want to see these guys coming at all. Attorney Harry Daniels and attorney Wayne B. Kendall. I'm good friends with them both. These cats are some of the most inquisitive and caring lawyers you can have. And I mean that. Attorney Harry Daniels spoke with Indisputable. Let's go to it.
And so the injury, he gets out of the car, slams him to the ground, they pull out aspatons, they call him boy, beating him, tase him 4 times, get him in cuffs, and allow his canine dog to lock in and bite the hell out of Antonio is unconscionable. As you can see from the pictures and the video, he was in handcuffs, and you can see the pictures of his body. This dog, these scars still here today. This dog is biting and locked in on Antonio. So to look at these videos, it's a sick thing to watch. From the beginning, that he would resort to a unreasonable force that could have killed him, then subsequently pulling him out of his car and beating him and letting the dogs beat him. This is a scene out of Jim Crow era, and it's 2023 and it's still happening.
Okay. So obviously the report is going to reflect that they had to do a pit maneuver because the individual was trying to avoid being pulled over. This is obstruction and you expect to see this, right? No, put up the report. Risco's lawyers, they say he was actually charged with possession of a controlled substance. Nothing about fleeing the police or obstruction. That's the incident report. Here is Lamar County Sheriff Brad White. Buck stops with him. You see, Brad, either A, your deputies are aware that you are down with the program, or B, they are aware that you are a feckless leader. It's one or the other. A representative of the Lamar County Sheriff's Office could not immediately comment, but did say she would ask the sheriff for a response. And madam, we're gonna wait, and hopefully the sheriff gives a response this week, but this story is going out today. Now, 2020 is when this happened, 2020. They hid the video, did not want anyone to see it. As a matter of fact, they wrote the incident report so nobody would question the other stuff that happened. It could have killed this man. Ms. Dahl, thoughts?
Okay, maybe you can help me answer this. So his car is facing the opposite direction of the traffic. So did they have him turn around? Is that what happened? Because from that video, honestly, where he is stopped is so dangerous. I can't believe they were even trying to get him out of the car there because he's right next to basically like the fast lane going in the wrong direction.
Yeah, you are right. The pit maneuver turned the whole vehicle around.
Yeah, that's, I mean, right. That's crazy. That just in itself seems so dangerous.
Yeah.
Why, you know, and you could see he had his hazards on in that video. And you can also see how angry that police officer is before even getting out of his car. The way he's yelling at him to pull over, like you already are like, okay, this person has already lost his temper. And, you know, so it sounds great that your friends are representing him, and it's probably why he finally got this video.
Yeah.
That's a crazy, really crazy video. Yeah.
Yeah. And not only could he be dead, other people driving could be dead. And every policy that I have read, Ms. Dahl, about when to use a pit maneuver always talks about, but you have to do it in a way that does not create danger for other people. You have to do it in a way that literally is safe, and it has to be absolutely necessary in order to stop the threat. There was no threat, there was no criminal penalty, there was no charge, there was nothing here but a frustrated cop. 2 minutes, he was following the guy for 2 damn minutes. All right, we're gonna bring you updates as they come, and I guarantee you they will.